Hey. You're not supposed to be here. What are you doing here? You're supposed to be asleep. Oh no. Oh no. You're staying awake, aren't you? To see him. To see the boss. Oh dear me. Seems like my cover's been blown now. I can understand why you want to see him. You know, I see him every day. I'm used to it. It's the first time I've ever encountered anybody seeing him. Know what I'm supposed to do. Oh dear. Who am I? Sorry. Disguise. Yeah, I know. I'm an elf. This didn't give it away from you. No, I am the master locksmith and strategist. I come here before to ensure that the boss has a way for getting into the house. I come an hour before and examine the place, make sure it's safe for him to come, because he is a very important man after all. And then I check the chimney, and then if there's a front door, yes. Mm-hmm. It's very hard work after all. Very dangerous work as well. I had to go through the 7 levels of Candy Cane Forest, and through the sea of swirling, twirly gumdrops to get through here. Hope you appreciate it. Yes. I work very hard, what I do. Now you better go to sleep. You better go to sleep. Because I'm going to be an awful lot of trouble. I mean, so much trouble when I go back to the North Pole. Then I'm going to know about this. You stay awake and you see him. And you blabber on about. I mean, no offense. I don't normally swear to being cotton headed ninny muggins. I'm sorry, but you are. Yes. I don't know. It's an elf thing. Don't ask. What am I supposed to do? A human. Supposed to trust a human. I can't trust a human. Unless I send you to sleep. Well, yes. I mean, it's one of the hardest things to do. Growing up as a child, ever to fall asleep on Christmas. I should know. Oh, the difficulties of growing. So, I'll aid you in your difficult time of need and try to send you to sleep, so then when you wake up, you won't remember a thing. Well, hopefully, you won't remember me, really, me. Well, I'm sure I can make an exception. You. You're awfully sweet, aren't you? No. Yes, you are. Okay, so I'll try to send you to sleep. What sends me to sleep? Well, normally when people brush my hair, especially when Buddy reads a story to me. It's an elf there. So, would you like me to push your hair? Don't worry, I've got a cushion here anyway. For emergencies. Yes. Really? I can't believe this happened. It is the first house I've been to. And it has happened. It's awfully annoying. Completely. Anyway. I keep this brush. And it is a good old brush. Called a tangle teaser. Awfully strange name for a brush. Would anybody want to be teased? Makes me awfully sad. Makes a cool noise nicely. All elves brush light nicely. So, have you been a good child this year? Would you have? Well, that's what you say. But I'm here after all, so there must be a reason. Strange colour though, isn't it? I'm not. Bloody hell. Carl, I would love to read it, won't we? I suppose. I'm sure you know this poem. Most people do. But I still love it, even though most people know it. Don't know if you can see it. But it says, "Twas the night before Christmas, when all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. Except for you, of course. Stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And Mama in her kerchief, and I in my cup, settled our brains for a long winter's nap." Let's see here. That does a lot of food out. And a peculiar cat seems to think it's funny to rock on a chair. And a ghostly rocking chair, apparently. This place must be haunted as well. Anywho, next page, of course. What a grand idea. And here we see the reindeer. Oh dear God, I cannot deal with the reindeers. All the time, constantly. But anyway. Cute. More rapid than eagles. His horses, they came. And he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Kwanzaa. And Vixen, own Comet and Cupid, and Donna and Blitzen, to the top of the porch, to the top of the wall. Now dash away, dash away, dash away all. As dry leaves sat before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky. Horses, they flew, with a sleigh full of toys, as St. Nicholas too, and mazes bought them, to be honest. Don't mean to be nasty, but he's rather a big fellow. Yes, we had to go to a specialist the other day. Way too. Chimney, that is my job. See, I make sure that he is safe. So face off or anything, no. No, I just get forgotten about. Person we haven't seen everywhere. And then, in a twinkling, I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof as I drew in my head and was turning around. Down the chimney, St. Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed in all fur, from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. And he looked like a peddler. Oh, a bundle of toys he had flung on his back. I'm also a dyslexic elf. Not very helpful, that's why I'm a locksmith. Anyway. Of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler who just opened his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. Oh, what a lovely sight. See, there's no child there, is there? His dull little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard on his chin was as white as snow. The stump of a pipe he had held tight in his teeth, and the smoke had encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed. Chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf. And he laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink in his eye and a twist of his head. Soon he gave me to know I'd nothing to dread. A word, but went straight to his work, filled odd stockings, then turned with a jerk, and laying his finger aside of his nose, and giving a nod up the chimney he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle. But I heard him exclaim, ere he drove out of sight, "Happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night." And of course, that was the night before Christmas. I see you're getting rather sleepy. Yes, see you. Sure, you can sleep down here. I'll stay here a bit longer.